Greetings. A Mohammedan posted a comment on my channel within the past few days. And that video you posted of Islam being the Antichrist, you and I both know that it is complete horse feces. And this video is my response to his comment. October 31st, 2010, Iraq. 8 terrorists stormed Our Lady of Salvation Church in Baghdad during Mass, slaughtering 58 worshippers and 2 priests. Afterwards, Al-Qaeda in Mesopotamia issued a bulletin claiming that all Christian centers, organizations, and institutions, leaders and followers, are legitimate targets. This slaughter took place during Mass. December 24, 2010, Nigeria. Christmas Eve assaults killed 32 and injured over 50 Christians in mixed-faced cities of Jos. These were Christmas Eve worshippers. December 25th, 2010, Philippines. A bomb explosion during Christmas Day Mass on the predominantly Muslim island of Jolo wounded a priest and 10 churchgoers. Again, this was during Mass. January 1, 2011, Egypt. A terrorist bombing killed 21 and wounded over 70 Coptic Christian worshippers as they left a New Year's Mass at Saint's Church in Alexandria. They were leaving a Mass. The Christians were only celebrating their religion. Not rioting, not bombing, not killing, not raping, not hating. In 4 separate attacks, in 4 separate countries, Islam demonstrated it likes to kill Christians. Islam kills Christians when they have done nothing. Islam kills those who simply worship the Christ. It is clear that the real agenda of Mohammedism is to attack Christianity, and this continues to become more clear with each passing month. He, the Mohammedan, continued his post. Islam will grow and grow and grow. More Christians will keep converting and converting and converting to Islam in large numbers, with or without you. He seems to think this taunt is demoralizing, as if the message is about me. But I agree with him. Islam will grow. I am sure the Mohammedan would be surprised that I would declare such a thing. But what does God say about the quantity of followers? Matthew 7:13. Enter ye in at the strait gate, for wide is the gate, and broad is the way that leads to destruction, and many there will be which go in thereat. Matthew 7:14. Because straight is the gate, and narrow is the way which leads unto life, and few there be that find it. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing, but inwardly they are ravening wolves. Read that again. Beware of false prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing. False prophets, which come to you in sheep's clothing. Sheep's clothing means claiming to be of the same God, of the same faith. Perhaps they claim to be another prophet after Jesus. Let he who has eyes to see, see who is the ravening wolf of violence. The Mohammedan continued, if Islam wasn't the true religion, so many, many people would never convert. And what does God say about such a departure from Christianity? Amos 8:11. Behold, the days come, says the Lord God, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord. 1 Timothy 4:1. Now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the latter times some shall depart from the faith, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. 2 Thessalonians 2:3. Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day, meaning the day of the Lord, shall not come except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition. This, of course, refers to the Antichrist. The departure we now see is a sign that Jesus is coming soon. The rise of Islam we now see is a sign that Jesus is coming soon. Soon we will also see the son of perdition take his position leading Islam. Remember, the truth is not determined by large numbers. Straight is the gate, and narrow is the way that leads unto life, and few there be that find it. The truth is what God has revealed by his prophets. The truth is Islam is the religion of the Antichrist. Look up, for your redemption draws near. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.